Hello dear chess friends, this is Grandmaster Leonid Kritz for chesslections.com. Today I'll show you another game between Pantala Harikrishna and David Navara from their match in Prague. And this game is particularly interesting because of the approach that White chose in the opening. The moves that White made look just terrible and like nonsense. But in reality today, it may make sense because what Pantala wanted is basically get out of the opening theory and get simply a playable position. And he got it and he outplayed his opponent at 2700 Grandmaster. So I guess this is something that modern chess is supposed to look like. Yeah, but let's see what actually the opening was. So e4, c5, knight f3, d6, d4, c takes d4, queen takes d4. So far so good. Basically the main line now is mostly knight c6, then bishop b5, take on c6, knight c3 or c4 and so on. So what Navara plays is knight f6, definitely a reasonable move. And now Harikrishna goes for bishop e2, which to me makes no sense, because now after knight c6, you have to move the queen away. And what is the queen doing on e3? What is this for a Sicilian? How can black be even slightly worse here? What if he plays e6 and then queen c7 and a6? Looks like Rauser with the queen on e3, knight on f3. But is he going to play f4 somehow? Is he going to play c4, g4? What's the plan? I don't know. The same with dragon, g6. Still good enough. Yeah. So basically everything goes except for what Navara started doing. Bishop g4. This move makes sense occasionally if you really want to take on f3 and the square d4 is weak. If you can get that square, yes, okay, bishop g4, get out, exchange, get the square. But the pawn is still on c2. Yeah, how do you plan to get that square? All right, so bishop g4, short castle, g6, rook d1. White is doing everything correct now. He threatens to play e5. I don't know, maybe queen c7. Would be an option, but then knight c3 may come, and there is potentially to play either knight d5 or knight b5. So already black a little bit messed up, yeah? So the most natural reaction to this bishop e2, queen e3 nonsense would be e6. With bishop on g4, white kind of got what he wanted a little bit. And now black takes on f3. So white didn't even have time to lose, time for h3. Black just takes, bishop takes f3, bishop g7, and c4. And to be honest, I don't think this is the best move to play, because pretty fast black gets a reasonable counterplay. In my opinion, in this pawn structure, if I can play c3 and kill the bishop on g7, then I should do that. It's an open position, I have a bishop pair. The center is open, I have space, black has absolutely no counterplay. All I need to do is just to finish the development. So after I play c3, I can either play knight a3 and knight c2, and then think, do I want to go for d4? Or I can play something like knight d2 and maybe then knight f1, move the queen to a normal position finally, the bishop will go to e2. So definitely white is just better without any counterplay for black. But no, of course, like c4, now the bishop becomes very strong, the square d4 becomes weak, queen c7, knight c3, knight e5, and b3. So this is the end of the strategy of white. If you have to play b3, give that bishop back, and have nothing, then definitely something went wrong. So to consider would be the alternative is bishop e2. You need to calculate what happens after knight c4. But there is a good chance white gets very good play after knight b5. For example, knight takes e3, knight takes e7, king d7. Then we have to calculate either bishop takes e3 and the rook ac1. Looks like good compensation, honestly. Bishop takes e3. Check. Where is the king going? To b8. Now I may start opening the position, maybe just sacrifice another pawn, e5. So should be enough compensation here. So bishop e2, of course, is a preferred way to play. And then b3 later. Alright, so b3, knight takes f3, queen takes f3. Absolutely equal position. Short castle. Bishop e3. Queen a5. Well, maybe queen a5 is good, but I would prefer to play a6, because my plan is b5. Yeah. And here I want to play b5 already. If white decides to go with bishop d4, then I want definitely to move the queen away, but I don't know where yet. Maybe I can play queen c6. Yeah, again preparing b5. Maybe even queen d7. But queen d7 doesn't look right because of the rook. Maybe still queen a5. I don't know. But definitely I think that I need to play a6. So he plays queen a5, rook ac1, and a6 now, which is fine. I'm just not sure about that. Queen on a5. Bishop d2. So, yeah, using the position of the queen. Rook fc8. This is, by the way, this is a good example. What rook do you want to put on c8? Because the rook on a8 seems to be dead, but in reality, if black plays b5 and the a file gets open, then the rook on a8 will play. The rook on f8 on the other side will never play. Even if you put the rook to d8, on d8 it's not going to do anything. The d file is not going to be open. Yeah, so rook fc8 is a solution. And the queen in this situation also can go back to d8 and sometimes to f8 to help with bishop h6 plan. Alright, so rook fc8, h3. And yeah, so now black only needed to understand that b5 probably is not the best thing to do immediately. Maybe he has to prepare it a little bit more. Either play rook c6, his idea rook c8. And b5 then, or move the queen away, like queen e5. He plays b5. I bet that he probably calculated something like knight takes b5, queen takes a2, and he probably saw that there is nothing going on here, so the position is good. But white has two options. One is he can play knight d5, this is what happened in the game, and the second one is much more interesting, really nice variation actually. White can give up the pawn. e5, d takes e5, and knight a4. Oops, the queen on a5. That's a problem. The queen c7 is bad. As I take, the queen hangs. Done. And queen d8 is bad too. Then the bishop e3, the queen has to move. Knight b6. And again, white is much better. So I think after e5, white would be winning, actually. But okay, so it's rapid, so he hasn't seen it, but knight d5 is good enough. Queen d8. Don't move. And now, of course, we don't take on f6, because the whole idea of knight d5 is to force black to take on d5 somehow. So that he takes, I take, and then I get the square c6 and the c-file, and try to put my rook on c6, and this is eventually what happened in the game. It's very difficult, but otherwise there is no point in all this. So bishop e3, knight takes d5, c takes d5, and rook c3. And honestly, I don't understand it at all, like, why not to play bishop b2? Yeah, just take the square c1 under control, and eventually almost force white to play rook takes c8. I don't think rook c6 works in this situation. First of all, I might have queen d7. The square c1 is still taken. Or I may even be able to take and play rook c8. And maybe I will be able to get the pawn on c6. Queen e2, bishop c3, rook c1, b4. Well, actually, no, b4 doesn't work because the pawn a6 hangs. So maybe then bishop a3. For now, and then try to just to play around this pawn, because the rook is attacking, the square c1 is controlled. But I think queen d7 is also good enough. So anyway, rook c3. Now white gets a little bit of an advantage, he takes on c3. Bishop takes c3. And the rook c1. Rook c8. So definitely the bishop doesn't want to go. And also note that before, this is a two-sided move. On the one side, it's good, I'm fixing the bishop on c3, but on the other side, I'm giving up the white squares, I'm putting the pawn on the dark squares, and the same color square as my bishop. White can play queen e2, later he can play a4, maybe he can play a4 immediately instead of queen e2 to fix the pawns, and this will be kind of dangerous. I don't want to weaken all the pawns and to weaken all the white squares and put all the pawns on black. I really don't want to do that. So in the ideal scenario, I just exchange the rooks, get the c-file, and offer a draw. But that doesn't work so easy. Queen e2, queen a5, rook c2, rook c7, queen d1. So the queen is going to c1. I want to pin the bishop. But in this situation already, I don't see it as a big problem, because here I really may be able to play b4, because my queen on a5 is already active, so my rook is on c7, I'm controlling many squares. I don't see it as a big risk. The queen can go to b5, so maybe that's not an issue. But black plays bishop e5 and probably totally overlooks that now the rook can go to c6, and it will be very difficult for black to stop the pawn, because now he has to take, otherwise he gets queen c2. He has to take d takes c6. And how are you going to stop the pawn? I want to play queen c2, and if queen c7, then bishop b6. For example, if you start moving the king, and done. You have to go to c8, but this position is already, like, I'm sorry. Yeah, so I have a very serious threat here. And also after queens, something like queen c3, I simply have queen c1, exchanging the queens with a threat c7. One. So before, so the idea is I want to block the c-file with the bishop and then put the queen on c7. But it doesn't work so well. f4. Bishop f6, queen e2, the queen goes to c4, e6, to allow the bishop to control the square. c7, but that weakens the pawn on d6, so queen d3, d5, after queen c7, queen takes a6. Remember the weakness of the white squares, so the diagonal got open. So the queen really cannot move. Let's try d5. E takes d5. E takes d5. And bishop d4. The very simple solution of a very simple, actually, problem. So bishop takes d4. Queen takes d4. And this endgame certainly is lost. So I want to play queen a7 and so on. So queen c7, and black resigned without even waiting for white's move, because white can either take on d5, but the simplest thing probably is to play queen c5 first, protecting the pawn, then play g3 or bring the king to f2, f3, or maybe even king e3, king d4, and so on. So this endgame, black has no chance to keep. All right, so to summarize, interesting but very suspicious opening from white. Definitely bishop e2, queen e3 cannot be good. The easiest way for black is not to invent the bike, but to simply play e6, the classical Sicilian, and ask white, like, what did you think when you played queen e3? And definitely this idea with bishop g4, bishop takes f3, that was wrong. But after all, this whole position, you can see it from RSC and from some hedgehog systems. The most important is when the knight goes to d5, who gets the c-file? This is a very good example of how not to play this position with black and how actually to play this position with white. All right, I hope you enjoyed this. This is Leonid Kritz for chesslectures.com, signing out.